Reef Stick. Thank you for switching your $2 tier to the $7 tier. And It's Not Kier. And SMBLMNL. Thank you for becoming a patron. You are what keeps the dream alive. Alright, let's get into it. I can feel him. Squeeze the trigger. They are on the objective. I can feel him. Bad guys are in your area. They are on the I can feel. Squeeze the trigger. Flashbang. I can feel. He's molesting me. Oh boy, what a headache that was. What's up everybody, Durag back at it again with another video on Ready or Not, and today we are going to be talking about what the hell just happened, because what you and I saw and everybody else saw did not make the game look good, like, whatsoever. So before we get into the nitty gritty, I thought that I would talk about what happened first. So first, I didn't even know that this was going on to begin with. Yeah, they didn't tell me jack shit. Like, if I didn't have any connections with bigger YouTubers, I probably wouldn't have even known about the event or even got to play it. Like, the day before the event, I received a random tweet from a bigger YouTuber that I talked to on occasion. Yeah, you could thank Big Fry for pushing me through. He had asked me if I had actually known that this was going on, and I said, no, this is the first I'm hearing about it. I was like, wait, what? It's like a giant kick in the nuts, big slap in the face, because I've been covering this game and following this game for a very long time now, through thick and thin. But you know, I was like, okay, well, at least I got in as a guest, I guess. A day later, I was getting ready for the event. I was making sure that everything, you know, was good to go so I could start streaming, and as soon as the time came, I went live, and 30 minute delay. Okay, well, I guess I'll improvise for the next 30 minutes. 30 minutes comes and goes, and it's delayed indefinitely.
Was it postponed? You're serious. You're joking. Where does it say postponed? Oh, it says right here. Due to unexpected issues with our server provider, we are forced to postpone the event window until further no- Are you fucking kidding me? We are sorry for the inconvenience, and we are currently actively looking to fix the issue to reach a resolution. Big fucking oof. Big fucking oof. I was all excited, like, yeah, let's go fucking play some Ready or Not! I don't remember where it's at, but I had a video basically stating how I was worried how Ready or Not doesn't always keep their word. And, like, they'll tend to, like, last second everything, like, oops, sorry, what, we're gonna have to actually delay it, like, the day of... the fucking date. Like, tell me in advance if you're gonna, you know,
leave me hanging. Typical Void Interactive to delay on the date and time of when an event is supposed to start. Do you understand how embarrassing it is to try and get people to like a game when it's the devs that keep botching it? I mean, this basically applies to every game, but for them to not test this like a week in advance, or turn the servers on to make sure that they're already on before we get in there, you know? It just makes the devs look incompetent, and makes me look like a fool for supporting them. I mean, I get that this one wasn't actually their fault, but still, the blame lies on them for not checking in advance. I mean, I get that this event was just slapped together, but that's the issue. Don't slap together an event, especially not with the build that we played. Speaking of which, the same day they contacted us basically saying that the servers were back up, so they invited all the attendees to a Discord, which again, they should have done that a week in advance. I was basically able to see all the big streamers and YouTubers, and they were pretty much all like Siege players or Call of Duty players, it seems. Rarely any people that are like into tactical games. And then the servers went up. Now, there were still some people who couldn't get in immediately, like even I had some issues in the beginning, but we eventually got in and got to play. And when I got into it, I just stopped and thought, whoa, everything looks so different. Like, for those of you that haven't seen my dream hack video, I'll leave a link at the top right if you want to go watch it, but this is the exact same map that I played at dream hack only this one is completely overhauled with an underground area. I kind of hope that they have the original map there, because it would be cool to play in that one too. Like, the map that I played at dream hack kind of looks a lot like a training map for this map. Like, you know how SWAT sometimes sets up like scenarios, they'll put up like a dummy map before they push in. That's what it kind of felt like. The menu screen where you choose your weapons and loadouts looks completely different and overhauled. Like, they actually have animations for you to look at while you're doing stuff. Although, the thing about the menu screen is that it feels very, like, unorganized. Like, a downgrade from what I played at DreamHack. Like, I have to, like, navigate my mouse all around to, like, specific areas of the thing and, like, use the middle mouse to scroll back and forth. Yeah, it's just very clunky. Like, if they could just do, like, a box in the corner with everything that's in that general area, like how they did with the previous menu screen, but just in, like, a tiny box form,
arm while the dude is like doing the animations as you're editing in that little box. That would be kind of cool. Like, keep the animations, but instead of having all the options all around the screen, like, put it in a tiny box is what I'm trying to say. Keep it simple. But yeah, aside from the UI, I definitely did see a lot of things that were added. They added in like a new type of helmet where it actually covers up your face. I've seen that in Escape from Tarkov, but I'm not entirely sure what that is. If anybody wants to let me know down below. But I really don't know how effective that was, because I've been shot in the face like a lot, so I'm assuming it helped. It's called the ballistic face mask. Now I'm gonna go through all the other ones here. We got the up armoring, which is just plate on top of the helmet, and then shooting glasses, anti-flash goggles, CBRN riot gas mask, and PVS 31 night vision goggles. And no face wear. I actually really like how you can put your logo in the game. I think that's pretty cool. And then they've got heavy and light armor. And the SWAT uniforms, they were actually like a lighter blue. It looks slightly different than what's currently in the alpha build. Switching over to the suspects, it seems as if they have a lot of things that are very makeshift. Like, a lot of the stuff has just been bolted onto the character. First, we got a ANPVS 31 night vision goggles, which I assume looks about the same as the one that we've seen in the trailer with the green. A CBRN riot gas mask, but it looks different from the police gas mask. Anti-flash goggles. These glasses look a lot like old-fashioned welding goggles. Then you got regular shooting glasses that don't look like it even fits on the character. And then you got a ballistic face mask, which looks more like a shield than a mask. And then up armoring, where they put more armor on top of the helmet. It doesn't look like it actually sticks to their helmet, so what they did is got like a bunch of netting and just like put the armor inside, put the netting over it so that it sticks on. The up armoring actually makes it look like they have like the flower symbol on their helmet. Also, I noticed on the left shoulder of this guy, he has a revolutionary American flag for a patch, which is interesting for another reason. Moving on to light and heavy armor. The heavy armor looks like they got a bunch of metal plates and just strapped them on. Like, I wonder what those metal plates are from, and it only seems to be like on their arms and shoulders. I think it's really cool how they put a lot of effort into these suspects. Like, I wouldn't have even thought to use welding goggles as a freaking a way to hide flashbangs. That's kind of a funny idea. But yeah, let's move on to weapons here, starting with the assault rifles. The first one we're going to start with is the SCAR-L, M16A4, M14, G36C, FAL, AR-18, and the G3A3. Moving on to the shotguns, we got the M1014. Isn't that the Benelli? I could be wrong. The 870 MCS, the M590 shotgun. Moving on to SMGs, we've got the MP5A2, UMP45, MPX, and the MPL. For the sidearm, we got a 5.7, a G19, an M2011, a P99, a 357 Magnum, and an M9 2FS. I know that there's a lot more lethal weapons, but it seems as if they're not showing all of their cards. So yeah, all of these weapons have a bunch of attachments, and unfortunately I wasn't able to like take a good look at them, so I just wanted to let you know that. I've also heard that a lot of people say that some of these weapons are inaccurate, but you're really gonna have to tell me what exactly is inaccurate, because I'm not a gun nut. But yeah, let's move on. We got the less than lethal weapons, the 590A less than lethal shotgun, which shoots beanbags, and the paintball gun, or pepper gun if you will, and the taser. One thing that I noticed is that whenever you switch to a lethal weapon, there's like a red light in the background. Whenever you switch to a less than lethal weapon, it turns blue. So is that like light and dark? But anyways, deployables. We have a C2 explosive, a door wedge, and pepper spray. You know the one thing that multiplayer was really missing? Doors. Because you can use C2 to blow open doors and actually kill people. And also you can use a wedge to stop people from coming in. Even if you were to blow the door open, you would have to use your multi-tool to actually disarm the wedge. So I think that's one thing that was missing from this multiplayer thing. No doors. But moving on, another deployable is the Opti-1, which would be useful if there was doors, and a breaching shotgun, again useful if there was doors, and an M320 with gas. Basically, this is a gun that shoots gas canisters. This will only affect you if you're not wearing a gas mask. They also had the shield that you could pick up, and it actually seemed to work pretty well. Also, it seems as if when you get shot on the glass area, the glass can actually break or look like it's broken. I didn't test it out too much, but it seemed like it was going in that direction. Also, the ladder was there. The ladder actually seemed to actually work. You set it down and then it fling up and then fall down onto the building, but I wasn't able to use it, it seems. So they're still working on that. For throwables, we've got a 9-banger, a flashbang, CS gas, and a stinger grenade. The stinger grenade was probably the most broken out of all of them. Now, the only difference between the suspects and the police officers is that the suspects get an AK-102 and the SWAT officers get an M4A1.
one.
Everything else is generally the same in terms of equipment.
The reason why I decided to go in detail about what was in this version of the alpha is because I believe that the developers actually care about their game. That's why I found that event to be baffling, that they would release such a broken version of the game to content creators with over 1 million subs.
What? Let's just run down the list here. The gun has too much recoil. People can walk through walls. There was too many disconnects on the US server. I couldn't even get back into a match.
When you tie someone down, they can still walk around like they're not tied down.
I really hated the running animation for the suspects. Like, that needs to go.
They still haven't added a default button to the menu screen so I can fix my fucking controls.
The gameplay wasn't bad, but it was overshadowed by how bad the audio was.
I'm capturing the point.
There are others here.
Securing position.
This zone isn't moving. This zone is being contested. Time to flood objective. We need to prepare for resistance. Additional victors have approached the combat zone.
Like, oh my god! Turn it off! Turn it off!
Oh yeah, to add insult to injury, anytime that you would go to the volume screen to try and turn down the game volume, the overlay would stay on your screen while you tried to go back and play the game. That effectively makes the game unplayable and forced me to restart the game. You know, the stuff that's here is obvious. Like, you flip on the game and you could actually see that. A lot of people in my comment section were basically saying how easy it is to fix this sort of things. If only they had people that saw this ahead of time. It's not like we have well over 6,000 people who paid $120, give or take, to test our game, you know, to find bugs, and they've been waiting around 3 months to get updates.
No, let's just show the multiplayer, you know, right? That's what all the trailers have been showing off, right?
This leads me to believe that they didn't even bother to test this. That somebody that was higher up decided to say, hey, why don't we show this off to a bunch of content creators? This is a great idea. Someone who's obviously disconnected from what the community actually wants. I honestly don't believe that it's the devs themselves, because the developers pulled an all-nighter and fixed all of the bugs. I was just shocked at how everything I just mentioned was all fixed, but that was too little too late.
The damage was already done. I'm going to continue to cover this game, but I just really hope that they start listening to the community more, because things were going well until they stopped talking to us. But those are just my thoughts. What do you think? Tell me what you think down below. I want to thank everybody for coming out to watch, and I guess I'll catch you in the next one. Bye-bye.